Hello and welcome to a Let's Play of Dawn of War, Soulstorm. This is very much like the Dark Crusade. Not quite, but initially looking at the game, it's almost identical. Get to choose, I think there were 7 races in Dark Crusade. Here there are 2 additional ones. Sisters of Battle and the Dark Eldar. And you have a solar system divided in regions that you fight over. But the basic concept is exactly the same as in Dark Crusade. It's a bit different though, because I think the rules have changed a bit how units behave or units. Air units have been added. And I think the artificial intelligence might be more capable than in Dark Crusade. I'm not sure which race I'm gonna play this with. I'll take normal difficulty.
It was the sudden appearance of a warp storm at the Kaurava system's outer edge that first caught the attention of the Imperium. And not just the Imperium. After hundreds of years under the neglectful watch of the Imperial Guard, nearly every force in the galaxy would descend upon the planet of Kaurava, bent only on domination and victory. 3 races had long dwelled in there. The Imperial Guard, its supposed rulers. The Orc tribes of Kaurava II, which the Guard had never successfully put down. And the Necron, who had slept undisturbed for untold millennia beneath Kaurava III. Where the Chaos Marines came from, or how, none can say. Did the Warp Storm bring them, or did they bring the Warp Storm? Both appeared suddenly on Kaurava IV, and in an eye blink, half the system's Imperial forces were gone. Killed or claimed by the madness of Chaos. In quick succession, the others flocked to Kaurava. The Space Marines, the Imperium's super soldiers, descended on Kaurava II, planning to finally cleanse the system, both of the troublesome Orcs and the Chaos Marines, the sworn mortal enemies. The Tau appeared next, not far above, on one of the planet's moons. In the interests of protecting its ordered empire from the effects of human folly, the Tau came seeking to contain the Warp Storm, and in so doing, expand the territory's border. On their moon, they built a mighty fortress, and there forged a space cannon capable of interplanetary devastation. Among the wastes of Kaurava III, the Necrons, perhaps awakened by the disruptive forces of the Warp Storm, slowly massed their lethal legions. In quick response, webway gates, long unused, flickered to life, and Eldar poured forth, ready to battle their dark, death-dealing adversaries. Meanwhile, in the shadow of an ancient portal gate, the Dark Eldar slipped stealthily out of the murky depths of the webway. They would be like carrion birds, flying above the battlefield, and when all were weary from the fight, make the battlefield into a feasting ground. Last to arrive, and perhaps most to be feared, were the Sisters of Battle, holy maidens and bearers of the God Emperor's faith. They had come to cleanse the system of corruption and filth. Their faith left them fanatical, unafraid of death and zealous in their cause. Nothing here was clean. All must be purged. Now, war rages anew, and only the victorious may write their history. Only the victorious will claim the planets of Kaurava.
Yeah, 9 races. Each starts with some kind of a bonus. I think it's attached to the stronghold. Arca Space Cannon, Deep Strike, Forward Bases, Fast Population Growth, Recover Lost Forces, Decrease Production Costs, Increase Movement Speed, Pre-Ancient Gate Travel, Ignore Supply Lines. I have no idea what most of these actually do. That's hardly important. I don't want to play with the Space Marines or the Orcs or the Imperial Guard. Those we played with already. I don't like the Eldar, so I'm not gonna play with the Eldar or the Dark Eldar. I think there was Chaos in Winter Assault. So, Sisters of Battle, Tau, or the Necron, maybe. Necron would be generally something a bit different. They don't have requisition. They rely on power only, and I think they get a reduced amount of it. Everything they buy has to be paid in power. It's terrible if you want to do some kind of quick early strikes with your forces, because it takes quite a bit of time to build up. But once you build up, you're a very capable faction, and I think they pretty much have the best relic unit. Their headquarters becomes a mobile fortress that is capable of moving and actually moving, because mobile fortress. But it's a fairly powerful combat unit that also regenerates and produces movements, and the only negative thing about it is that it's naturally fairly slow to move. But it can teleport around too, so But the thing is, if you need to do some kind of quick strikes, which are usually essential in skirmish missions, for example, Necron is not a good one for that. I think Sisters of Battle is sort of a mix between Space Marines and the Imperial Guard. They have their own special flavor, but I think that's where they more or less fall. And Tower Town. Very powerful, fast units. Ridiculous range on some of their units. I don't think they have quite the durability. I pretty much think they have to make a choice between doing those great vehicles and long range units versus doing some kind of melee focused units. They have to choose every time they want to specialize. I don't honestly know. I need to make a choice. I have a coin here. Yeah, that's good enough. Necron or Sisters of Battle? Necron and Tau or Necron? Who are Necron? You are Tau. Necron. I'm a bit worried how we'll deal with the tougher skirmish missions with this. We'll have to build up quite a decent single-player campaign of quite a decent honor guard. Right. We have a single region. We're here with the Eldar. I don't think we should really worry about what the others are doing at this point. We need to deal with the Eldar first, anyway. We need to build our honor guard. Might be best for us to actually try to push toward their stronghold as soon as possible. Uh, Looking at this, we're not gonna get much of a honor guard force here. Basic infantry wraith, which is sort of a heavy infantry unit, a single unit that's good at melee. You don't do it because you want to fight. It's a good scout, and I think it can spot infiltrated units, so it's a spotter. And then anti-infantry vehicle, destroyer. Fast-moving unit, good for raiding. The thing is, this is not much of a raid group. So, the moment they get decent defenses, like 5 I think is the limit, they're going to be a tough opponent for us. Especially since Eldar have very easy and cheap quick units. Our units are few in number, slow, and they might be a little bit sturdier. I don't know if this is good or not. Ancient gates are our only means of traveling from one planet to another. But this doesn't really give us anything but the gate, and I need to try to build up my honor guard units quickly, so let's hack this one. Skilled, competent, basic infantry, single base, shouldn't be too much of a problem. Kir Harrah. Instead of requisition, we have time bonus. Time bonus is not going anywhere at the moment. And every resource requires power and power alone. Basic infantry I'm producing doesn't really cost anything. Upgrades on these cost nothing. They're producing them cost nothing. We can build turrets wherever we want. I think we can build something like 4 turrets per monolith. Not exactly a huge amount. Buying additional units will cost energy again. Energy which we don't really have. What else? We need to build obelisks because it increases both our population cap and our time bonus. think that's enough basic infantry for us. Well, it's spree. And it's the only thing we can rely on at the moment. So might as well build more. We can always destroy it if we don't want it later. There's an extra power source there, we could go after that. Can we? No. Let's upgrade our monolith first. 340. Yeah, without this we can't really do much. Once that's done, we can at least do some basic things. Okay, they probably started on one of these two sides. Do other types of infantry. Okay, what can we do? Do we need the Forbidden Archive? I'm not quite sure we do. Could use with some played ones. We could use some vehicles. Raider summoning core, okay. Basically a vehicle shot. Greater summoning core, enhanced disruption field. So these should units be somewhat useful after that point. I just don't see how we're gonna do any kind of a quick assault with these guys. I just don't see it happening. We would have to have a fairly substantial amount of energy right from the start, then I could see it happen. But otherwise, it might be better to... All the energy basically goes to upgrading, and it's just taking too long. We're about to reach the 10 minute point, and it's just taking way too long. These troops are no longer sufficient. where they're just not gonna be able to do things. I just don't want critically to use my energy either on developing them. Their entire point was to hold things together while I figure out what exactly I want to do. No, I can do better units. I don't mean we shouldn't try to at least get a squad or two into some kind of fighting shape. They're gonna need this basic infantry anyway. It's not like they're bad or they're too slow. They're more of a decent defensive unit than something I can really engage the enemy with. Engage. Okay, I think I'll use this squad basically as a defense force. I will use the vehicles to attack still. How much can I increase the population cap by upgrading the obelisks? Can I do anything with it? Quite sure what exactly we're getting if we use these certain sort of upgrades. It's more important to control the site than it's try to upgrade the obelisk itself. So I know what we can do with this. Energy core. This is needed to activate a monolith. Contains research to allow the Necron Lord to manifest powerful essence. I don't care about the essences. Phylactery. Greatly reduces amount of range damage Necron Lord takes. Automatic repair. Solar pulse, maybe resurrection. And we're at our unit cap. There should be a tomb spider somewhere. So, the vehicles are the fast attack units we have. Infantry is much more better at a defensive role. The problem I sort of have with Necron, I guess, at this, besides the slow start, is that we need to be sort of aggressive, otherwise we can't reach our potential anyway, because our unit cap is tied to that control. So, while it sort of seems to benefit that you hold your ground, try to develop things, you can't actually do that. You just can't. Well, they didn't start from here. These are less developed than the areas here. Okay, what person? This is pretty much it. So, learning experience for us. Some spiders are actually quite a bit better than the destroyers, even though you get them earlier. They don't require quite so much unit cap either. We have a population limit. This can create some kind of a attack scarabs, but I guess it takes up vehicle cap, so we can't do it. And without the obelisk, we don't really gain anything from controlling the resource. It's all tied to that. So we want to do some kind of an early game assault. It has to be the Lord itself, but maybe try if we can get access to Tomb Spiders. And he has additional assembly. It's a smart thing to do, but I don't recall the enemy doing that in Dark Crusade. So it's definitely more dangerous here. I really need to learn how to use some of these units. Big problem I have, I mean, just in my behavior, is that I don't actually know how to use the scarabs effectively. You have to. They both can spot infiltrating units, and you have to stretch your control. Usually you can just pile up your combat units. One of them can take control, but not here. It has to be scarabs. I'm gonna try to see what it's required for the monolith. This is probably going to be one of the easiest fights we'll ever fight, so let's all take advantage of it. We don't need the relic and energy core. The sort of problem we have with the using scarabs too aggressively is that the obelisk does not have any defensive capability. You need to upgrade it twice before it even gets a basic attack weapon, and I think it's mainly an anti-vehicle weapon. So we'd have to build these ghost turrets to protect them. We can build something like 4. So it's a don't know what would be the good way, honestly, the good way to deal with them. I suppose you might want to take into consideration that you can build multiple monoliths if you have the extra energy, but it's taken a long time for us to even reach the 1000 points we have. I think our capture speed too is abnormally slow. Stored my way. More or less just want to see how good it is. It should be slow enough that it's actually aggravating to use if we need to do some kind of quick strike. Only 1000 points of health, no melee capability, but a lot of range damage, can produce new units. We can also summon our own units, at least some of them, to this particular structure. Necron summoning. Summon the selected unit to a Necron building anywhere in the game world, so if we can get the monolith to go somewhere, we can basically transport an army right on top of it. Where's the next assembly? I'm a bit worried about it because, yeah, definitely not here. He has the capability of turning his own units invisible. I don't think he's on this side. You go with them. I need something that can spot potential infiltrators. If they have a cloaked assembly hall. I've never been able to find it. That reminds me, we might want to consider that. I'm pretty sure we have an upgrade on the Lord that is able to team the hidden units. We're not gonna need to mull it here. I just don't see that happening. Ooh. Yeah, I can't see the webway gates. So you need to destroy all the buildings, not just the webway assembly. Oh, that changes things, because my tactic so far of trying to win these certain level skirmish missions is to basically go for the assembly and end things by just destroying it, but that's not enough. So if we have the situation where the enemy has two bases, it's we cannot just spend a couple of minutes to wipe out one base and then prepare to fight the other. Just wiping out one base is going to take some time, because you can't just go for the HQ building. You have to wipe out everything before the factions wiped out. And it's important because their units will not go away until everything is wiped out. So if there's some kind of a unique production site they have, it's another faction that is able to use its full population cap support the other side, so it could potentially lead to a lot of trouble. Death Mask reveals infiltrated units, increases health. We don't absolutely have to have this, and it might be better to have a more useful lord, but at the same time it's scarabs or raids at this point if we want to do spotting. And one of the special abilities the Lord can take is also spot those units through a special ability. The thing is, if we take this, we will not have to take that upgrade. It's worthless. I'd like to have this simply because we're surrounded by Eldar, and they're one of the worst abusers of the infiltration, so I'd like to have some kind of capable frontline unit that can at least spot that trouble. Otherwise, hunting down their structures, especially since it's mandatory to win these scenarios, is gonna be a huge pain in the ass. It might still be, but at least now it should be a little bit more convenient for us. Right. Not sure if we want to buy this. 325 requisition points. We get what, about 150 each turn. What I'm saying is, let's say we reinforce this. It is 300, it's 85. And this probably has more people in it than the other group. So might be a better use of requisition points at this point to just reinforce these instead of trying to increase the underguard. Underguard is better when we attack the strong, but just for defensive purposes, right. Troop recovery. Troop and vehicle emergency teleportation devices allow some damage or isolated forces to be recovered after the battle. Some underguard and garrison units will be recovered after each battle. So it'll save us some requisition points. Makes sense to me. Very Necron type of special ability. Can't reinforce everything. But I think something like a Tomb Spider would be a better purchase than these infantry squads we can do, because he's not gonna have pretty much anything that can counter these to start. sure if we want to reinforce the stronghold though. He's much more likely to attack here. Still, we do have to have the honor guard because I'm pretty much going to attack his stronghold. Maybe not Nyx, but I might take on something like this. So another one of these easy areas and then go for it, just to increase the honor guard a little bit. I don't want to get into any even half serious fight. Sure if I have the points to reinforce these. I'll buy the spider, just in case we'll have to do some kind of a offensive fight. Which brings me to my first complaint. Why are the region maps so goddamn small? I mean, it's a handful of planets, but this is the area for the regions, and if I'm being generous, I mean including the empty space between the planets, it's still probably more than 50% of wasted space here. And I can barely see some of these regions and the numbers they have. So, I mean, what a badly designed combat map. This planet should basically not be in any kind of scale. They should have just plant them wherever and just increase their size as much as the area here allows. Maybe even have some kind of scrolling map so you can focus on to a planet at a time or something like that. Either way, it looks sort of nice, the storm there and sun there, but they're totally worthless. And the storm could have been something as simple as some kind of a background effect. So it just seems like a huge waste of space to have these, whatever these are intended to be. Some kind of a futuristic info screen or something like that, but it doesn't show anything useful. It's totally worthless, just waste of space. What do they have? Fleet march. Advanced road and transport systems allow for extremely fast movement within your own territories. Move up to 3 territories distance in your turn. Fleet march does not allow you to attack multiple times. So, it's fairly worthless. But I suppose it could have its uses. Now it's more of a question, are we going to try to expand our honor guard before going after the HQ? I'm somewhat interested in getting the destroyer. It's a very good anti-infantry unit. So if we go after their stronghold, we might require something like that. Currently we have the Lord with a single war gear piece and a shitty infantry unit. And that's it. And we have a faction that requires quite a bit of building before it can basically stand up itself. So, depending on what type of the stronghold mission is, it's probably very difficult for us to survive. Positively, we could also isolate him here. Yeah, because the great thing is he would have a region of 4 where he's going to very likely attack us. I suppose he can attack other planets too. The point is, his attacks wouldn't be super bad because they come from a region of 4 instead of a region of 12. So if we cut him off, we might be in a position to get a couple of defense missions that we shouldn't have too much trouble dealing with. At the same time, growing up our honor guard, getting some requisition points going. So we would be in a much better place once we go after the Eldar stronghold. Basically, maybe get these 3 regions here and then go. Leave him isolated here, maybe fish a few relatively easy defensive victories out of him. That means we might as well reinforce all of these a little bit. At least get the Tomb Spider in there. It would mean we would have at least one guaranteed unit that we could immediately use to harass and attack while we build up. I don't think we can handle all that much. Not against a faction like Eldar, with the faction we have. We have to have either initial troops that are non-Necron warriors, or we have to have our hero on honor guard, one way or another. Otherwise, I think we're going to be overwhelmed before we get going. It's 10 to 15 minutes at the least before we have any kind of decent thing going. And that's with the extra power I managed to get from the thermal plant. I probably just don't know how to build Necron up all that well. Probably should rely more on the infantry insurgents on their Necron warriors. They have very good melee units too. I don't know. But I'll leave things here. It's an okay start, but I'm a bit worried about the choice of playing with a Necron. It doesn't seem to be all that great of a match, how to my current playstyle.